People don't get this about the numbers game and what goes on behind the scenes. And Santorum, you know what? That's his bad. He keeps whining about the money and he's so outspent. So go raise more money and stop whining about it. Perceptually, I think it's terrible, as we were talking about before. But also the fact that he doesn't, when you go to his events in any of the local markets, you can see the difference between what his organization and the difference between Romney's organization. Romney just, he kills him everywhere, and that's something that you need to be able to do to really make a real run for the White House.
Right.
So I totally agree with you.
And here's the other thing. You know, there's lots of whining from Newt and Santorum about the money. But, you know, not qualifying in Virginia wasn't about money.
Exactly.
It's about you need to be organized and strategic about running a nationwide race.
Well, yeah,
it had nothing to do with money. Yeah. I mean, every candidate, down to dog catcher, have to go through the same process to get on a ballot in a particular state.
Yeah, no, I agree. I'm just saying, organizationally, money is just one part of the pie, but
exactly.
You can see the entire part. I mean, money is a byproduct of the entire part. If you can, if your organization is strong enough so that you can do well locally, and that you can, I mean, it all fits together. So I'm not saying that Romney wins because he has, you know, so many more ad dollars to spend. I'm saying Romney wins because he's running a better
campaign.
He's organized.
Yeah, he's organized. He's serious. He's like, I want to win this nomination. I'm going to be organized in every state. And I'll tell you, even Ron Paul, you know, we all talk about how he's got these energized folks, younger people, I should say, not folks, but younger people in all these various caucus states, but, you know, but he hasn't been able to win because it takes more than just having people on the ground.
That's right.
And people at your rallies. It takes a concerted, strategic effort.
And, you know, the thing is, I'm always amazed about it, if you think about it. If they think this part's hard, the part where they're trying to get the nomination, wait till you get the job.
Right.
If you think that 23 and a half hour days are just brutal on the campaign trail, wait till you're in the White House.
Exactly.
That's a really good point. And, you know, speaking of the fact that we've got a race that, as you pointed out earlier, is still going on well after Super Tuesday, and it looks like it's going to continue because both Gingrich and Santorum continue to say that they are going all the way to the convention. They have no intention of dropping out. Now, we'll see what happens as time moves forward, but at this juncture, and over the weekend I had Governor Huckabee on my show in Washington, and he was saying if we move towards this brokered convention idea, it's going to be a train wreck for the Republican Party. And it's going to give the Democrats, you know, the nominee, give them the
election. I never can get anybody to admit on this show that the longer the Republican, if you end up with a brokered convention, if that's where you're going to end up, that is just great news for Democrats. Sorry, but we love this.
I will tell you right now, I'm not in favor of a brokered convention. I do think that that would create lots of problems for us. I know that some people, including Sarah Palin, have said, you know, it'll energize the base.
Right.
I don't know about that. As an adult, I have not seen that, you know, so I don't know whether it would energize the base. I can't speak to that. But what I can say about this is that I don't necessarily think it's a bad thing for the nominees the longer this goes on. Again, I don't want a brokered convention, but I think here's the situation. Look who, you know, they're running against. The president can't get above 50%. He's got so many problems, 8.3% unemployment, and energy policy, which is non-existent, and sadly, his signature legislation he's running from.
But let me ask you this. I'm sorry to interrupt, but let me just ask you.
No.
The fact that they are fighting so vehemently against each other, trying to tear one another down, does that not look bad to the public at large? And aren't they weakening?
But, you know,
are they not weakening the eventual nominee?
You know, I'm not just sitting here spinning. I honestly don't think it is. You know, sometimes it's painful to watch. I will admit, sometimes it is painful to watch. But you know, it's kind of part of our democratic process. This is what primaries are like. I mean, look, just 4 years ago, Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton, who could say, I mean, that was a terrible fight. That went on until June, and look, now she's Secretary of State. So guess what? you get over it. Mm-hmm. They eventually do get over it.
Yeah, I mean, you do get over it. I agree with you, and that's the perfect example to cite. But look at what Romney's doing. I'm real curious what you think about this one. Is he suddenly did a little bit of a pivot, and he's not attacking Obama over the economy. Now it's the price of gas. And the price of gas does matter, but if the economy starts coming back, as it seems to be showing little signs of doing, I think that that's going to be a much larger problem, because I believe that Obama is running against the economy, not against whoever the Republican candidate is.